First of all, I just want you to understand that there are a number of job-related skills that employers will look at, and then there are a number of employability skills that different employers will value. In this video, we are going over five skills that employers tend to value. So the first one is self-management skills. This is one of those key skills that involves how you monitor, control, and direct aspects of work and work life. Now, some of the elements that you need to pay attention to as you are sorting your self-management skills will include things like punctuality, time management, planning, and organizing. This shows the employer your dependability by showing them that you are capable of doing the job, doing it well, and doing it on time. Other skills under self-management will include things like self-confidence, honesty, integrity, reliability, of which the idea here is to show the employer that they can trust you as well as the work you do. Good personal presentations, as well as coping with pressure, are also some of the skills that are required to boost your self-management skills. Now, the second thing that you sort of need to pay attention to as far as your employability skills are concerned is thinking and problem-solving skills. This is very, very important because, look, you need to ask yourself, why are you being employed? And if your answer is because I have some papers or something, then think again, because many people outside there also have those papers. So you need to show the employers that you can assess a situation and solve problems on the spot, okay? Attention to detail, negotiation skills, decision-making skills, etc., will help show you a problem, okay? And thinking skills. Now, the third thing that you also need to focus on is working together and communication skills. Remember, once you get employed, okay, or as you're looking for employment, basically once you get employed, you'll be working with a team. You're just going to be sitting in an office and working alone. So you need to demonstrate that you are capable of working with other people. Even if you're highly introverted, you still need to show that because you'll be dealing with customers, okay? And if you're not dealing with customers, you'll be dealing with other colleagues. And so you need to show that you are in a position to actually communicate with other people. So the fourth thing that you'll need to also show the employers that you're good at is understanding business. Can you show the employer that you can help their business grow? So whoever is employing you either owns a business or is part of a business. And so it's your duty to prove to this person that you understand the business, that you can take their business from here to all the way, wherever it is that they want it to be. And so understanding business is important. It's not just a question of, I get employed, I do my job, you guys pay me at the end of the month. For them, it's more of, you just happen to be part of the human resource because they need material resource and they need human resource. So if you, as a human resource, you're not helping them to get where they want in terms of business, then they don't need you. So again, it's not just a question of I have skills. It's a question of, can those skills translate to something in our business that will help our business to grow? So you need to demonstrate that you understand the business. Now, the fifth thing that you need to demonstrate is functional skills. These are basically skills that are related to the job you're applying for. For instance, if you're applying for an accounting job, then you need to show that you understand accounting. So in this case, if you're trying to be a CPA and you really, really don't like maths, that's kind of is interesting, okay, because it's not going to work out for you. So whatever job you're applying for, what functional skills do you have in relation to that job?